Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the current URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type it, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived at this point on our own website of Usitility, exactly where we get a meticulous outline on the way to obtain Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin on PC. We browse lower a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. Which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin on our PC. As you can see here we access a number of pros of preferring that emulator. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on that button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to run the installer, okay, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We answered yes. I reduced the internet browser to start to see the installer better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of two choices, install and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path does indeed. We only click it, and then we realize that we display here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we are planning to modify this folder we need to click on the Browse option, and we decide on another folder and set up the emulator wherever we wish. I am going to keep it by default. Then, I click on Back. And therefore I just click Install. Great, the setup commences and it's going to carry on together with the download of all these megabytes which are presented on the computer screen. When you download it, it is likely to be slightly more or less MB. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, based on your type of access to the web and depending on the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they are running really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right so when it comes to the finish, the emulator can be launched for the first time. Believe it or not the emulator has been started, here for the first time. Before we continue on, as you will notice, it created two software icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the one we are concerned about. Whenever we need to launch Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this specific icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the next phase, that is a requirement, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As can be seen the Google Play is started. In this case we must sign in. Right now once we're there, we have to accomplish this following step that is obligatory. So we mouse click on Sign In. At present it shows Checking Info. It might in some cases get blocked in Checking Info, and this fails to progress. In that case, you may attempt to log in after a couple of hours and it'll most probably be resolved. At present we can type our login name and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email address as well as its related password. For example, you make use of the same email you use currently in your own YouTube account. Thus I am going to type my data and I will go back as soon as I have completed it. That's all, info typed. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We can approve all of them by clicking, I agree. Then, it makes it possible to back up to the Google Cloud. You could let it checked and this will build a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We click Accept. The Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and immediately. To set up the app game, we would need to visit the Android emulator desktop by left-clicking this app icon marked green-colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of that Android emulator, we observe that we now have there the install application option. We mouse-click on the button. At this point we come with the Android game. Let's quickly simply click there on the install choice that I am showing now in green. This will launch the software setup. At present it should install the video game, it could take some time or it may possibly be very fast. It again all is determined on our own connection to the internet. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking the following button that I'm presenting in green. If you want to run Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin for the first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, then we're about to just click on the brand new Lost Sanctuary Eternal Origin app icon that's been created. That game app is started for the first time. Now there we have it, I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the sound level of this emulator. It's here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we won't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we could switch on the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is actually the very first one, we just click on this particular icon which I am indeed identifying in green. Then the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we need to launch the video game in full screen, we select that game icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing the game app in full screen function. To get out of the 100% screen setting, press the F11 key. And we might just end up being in regular computer screen setting. From now, I am on the way to clarify you the computer keyboard mapping that is actually surprisingly enjoyable. That means we will be ready to use the game application a lot more effortlessly. The very first point is to click this application icon. It's now time to complete the required configuration settings. I am about to let the standard settings, however if you desire to improve it, you may well do so without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is fully in our own language. Occasionally it happens that the emulator is presented in the incorrect language, for instance, in Chinese language. And as a result to place it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. So there throughout additional options, we simply click on the language drop down. We will pick the language we prefer, Spanish, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is determined, we could save, the emulator will reboot, along with the video game, next time we launch it, would of course be in the chosen language. Right now, you can find another point that we will need to take into account, and it is that we will get a message from Google Mail telling that a brand new device has been connected with our Google account. It will definitely question us if we're the people who have connected that device. Absolutely, we should not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is emulating in Google Android tablet or smartphone. And in order to determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model selection. And right here we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for my training. I anticipate you liked it, especially that you thought it was helpful. If so, bring it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any remarks, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams ever so often, you get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of those videos that happens to be appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next instructional videos. Bye.